गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, लेट अस स्टार्ट टुडेज क्लास। एंड इन टुडेज क्लास वी विल डू सम प्रॉब्लम्स। ओके, फर्स्ट वी विल डू सिंपल इजी प्रॉब्लम्स, देन वी विल डू सम टफ प्रॉब्लम्स। ओके, सो इन प्रीवियस क्लास वी हैव सीन द फॉर्मैट ऑफ कैपिटल गेन फॉर्मैट। सो फॉर्मैट इज लाइक दिस। सो वी फर्स्ट डू सेल कंसिडरेशन, from that we deduct sale expenses, we get net consideration. Next we do index cost of acquisition. Index cost of acquisition we do for long term capital assets. Then we do index cost of improvement for long term capital assets. Okay, so gross capital gain and exemption under section 54, and we get net capital gain. So today we'll understand the meaning of indexation. So previous class we have seen cost of acquisition, cost of improvement, and we have seen transfer expenses also. I will see today what is the meaning of indexed, why we do index the cost of acquisition for long term capital assets, why we do indexation. Okay, so what is the meaning of indexation? See, let us understand in a simple way. We know inflation, right? Being economic students, we know inflation. Inflation means every year the price of the products or the price of the properties will increase, that is called inflation. Okay, so what is happening here? Take example, there is one person, his name is Mr. X. He purchased a house property. Okay, this is house property. Let us assume he purchased on 1999. He purchased this house property on 1999, or you take example 2000. He purchased the house property on 2000. In the year 2000, okay, let me do correction. So this property has purchased on 2000 for rupees 5 lakhs. Take example. Okay, now what he did? He sold the property in the year 1920 for rupees 5 crores. Okay, the property which he purchased on in the year 2000, he sold the property in the year 2019 and 20. So let us assume 2001 and 2001 he purchased. Now the property value has increased. Current year, what is the value of property? Is 5 crores. So I can write here 5 crore. Okay, now the value of 5 crores, that in 2000 and 2001, his value of 5 lakhs will be not same in the current year, in the current year to 1920, it will increase. Okay, now this 5 lakh value may be increased, right? See, if I take the same 5 lakh, let us do the problem. See, if I take sale consideration 5 crores and this is sale consideration, say transfer expenses assume nil, again it will come 5 crores. Cost of acquisition is, take example, 5 lakhs, 4 crores, 95 lakhs. It means the X has to pay tax on 4 crores 95 lakhs. What we have done? We have taken the 5 lakh value in the year 2000 2001, same value we have taken. We should not take that same value, because if we take the same value, there will be a loss to the party. So capital gain is 5 lakhs, 4 lakh 95 thousand. So he has to pay tax on 4 crores 95 lakhs. It's wrong calculation. Why? Means the 5 lakh value he has purchased in the year 2000 2001, the value will increase now. This 5 lakhs will increase now. Okay, so in which year he sold? He sold in the year 2019 and 20. So what we have to do? We have to do the value, this cost of acquisition, the cost of acquisition 5 lakhs, we have to do indexation. What will be the value of 5 lakhs today? The 5 lakh value in the year 2001 and 2001 is 5 lakhs, but what is the value of the 5 lakhs today in the year which he sold, to 2019 and 20? So to find out the value of asset purchased in some years back, we are trying to understand what is indexation. The value of asset purchased in some year back, in our example it is purchased in 2000 and 2001. So we want the value of 5 lakhs. We want the value of 5 lakhs, what is today? We want to know the 5 lakh value, what will be the value of today. Today means the year of purchase, the year of sale, sorry, year of sale. For us today means the year of sale. So when did we sold? We sold the asset in the year 2019 and 20. So we want to find out the value of 5 lakhs in the current year or in the year in which we sold the asset. Okay, that finding out of value of called as indexation. Okay, so finding out the value of that asset today is called indexation. Okay, so the prices of the products as property increases, right? Okay, take example, I'm taking the value of the house property is 5 crore. This is sale consideration, and transfer expenses I have taken nil. So net consideration I am taking 5 crores again. Okay, so take example, cost of and index cost of acquisition. We did the calculation. Suppose it is coming around some 2 crores. I'm just taking example. So the tax has to pay on 2 lakhs, 3 crores. So the person has to pay tax on 3 crores. Just example I'm giving. This calculation I'm done and I'm giving example. So if he does not do indexation, he has to pay tax on 4 crores 95 lakhs. If after doing indexation, the value is 3 crores and the capital gain is 3 crores, he has to pay tax on 3 crores. How much difference? 1 crore 95 lakh difference. Okay, so that's why we have to do indexation. Simply, what is the meaning of indexation? Sir, the value of the asset which is purchased in some previous year, that is 2000-2001, that value we want to know in the current year, the year in which we have sold the asset, that is called as indexation. For indexation, we are having formulas. Okay, so for indexation, we are having formulas. So what is the formula for index cost of acquisition, and what is the formula for index cost of improvement? That we'll do today. Okay. So at today's class, we have understood what is the meaning of indexation. So we'll understand how to find out the indexed cost of acquisition, and we'll find out how to, we'll see at today's class, index cost of improvement. Okay, so today we'll see in class index cost of acquisition, how to do, how to find out, there is a formula. Index cost of improvement, how to find out, there is a formula. That formula we'll see. Okay. Chale, let us start writing. In detail we'll understand. Okay, in detail we'll understand how to do index cost of acquisition. So I'm writing heading here as, give me a minute. Sorry for disturbance. Now let us continue. Index cost of acquisition. There are situations to understand. So indexed cost of acquisition. So we are having different situations that we'll understand. Okay. So index cost of acquisition can be discussed. Index cost of acquisition can be discussed. So we'll discuss. There are two situations that we have to understand. Okay, this is very important, which we are discussing. The whole chapter is based on this only: index cost of acquisition and index cost of improvement. If you know how to do index cost of acquisition and index cost of improvement, you can easily solve problems. Okay, so can be discussed under situations. Can be discussed under the following situations. Situation 1. when a capital asset, and I hope you know, you all know what is the meaning of capital asset. This is important. When a capital asset is acquired, when a capital asset is acquired by the SSE, and we know who is the SSE, the person who is liable to pay tax, before, when he is purchasing 1st April 2001, if any SSE, if he is purchasing the asset before 1st April 2001, okay, so we have a cost of acquisition will be, we have to take like this. So this is on the cost of acquisition, cost of acquisition, okay. Whenever in the problem, if he mentions the asset is purchased before on 1st April 2001, in a question there will be two things will be given. What will be given? First, fair market value. On 1st April 2001, or cost of acquisition. So in these two, whichever is higher, that we have to take as cost of acquisition. I repeat, whenever in the question if he says the house is acquired before 1st April 2001, okay, 1st April 2001, in that case we have to take cost of acquisition as fair market value on 1st April. This will be given in question. Whichever is highest, that will be taken as cost of acquisition. The highest of the two will be taken as cost of acquisition. Okay, when we do the problems, when we'll understand. Just remember that whenever the house property is purchased before 1st April 2001, you have to take cost of acquisition. Two things will be given in question: fair market value 2001 on 1st April 2001, and cost of acquisition. Two things will be given. Whichever is higher will be considered as cost of acquisition. Okay. Now, how to do now indexation? Now, so we'll write here index cost of acquisition. Equal to the formula we are having, we'll be taking this FMV or COA. FMV, or I'm writing in shortcut COA, whichever is higher, okay, into cost of inflation. Cost of inflation, that is indexed, inflation index for the year in which the asset is transferred, okay, now divided by, you have to do cost of inflation index for the year, cost of inflation index for the year 2001 and 2, okay, like this you have to do. So what is this cost of year in which asset is transferred? Means sale year, the year in which the asset is sold, that we have to take on the numerator. Denominator, cost of inflation index for the year 2001 and 2. Whenever the asset is being purchased in the year 2009, 1999, 98, whenever before 2001, in that case we have to write a cost of inflation index for the year 2001 and 2. The only this we have to take. Okay, so we have understood when the asset is acquired before 1st April 1990 2001. So what to do? How to find out index cost of acquisition? FMV or COA, whichever is higher, that you take, multiply this with in which year you sold the asset, divided by cost inflation index for the year 2001 and 2. Okay, check it. Now situation 2, this is situation 1 now. And now what is situation 2? Now what is situation 2? When an asset is acquired by the SSE after, when a capital asset इज अक्वायर्ड, SQRID अक्वायर्ड बाय द SSE when a capital asset is acquired by the SSE after 1st April 2001 means after 2001 if we purchase the asset, then in that case we have to write as cost of acquisition multiply, I'm writing CII, cost of inflation index shortcut, for the year for the year in which the asset is transferred divided by CII for the year in which the asset is in which asset is acquired okay done so this is a formula for we have two situation after that one more situation we are having some five situation actually all together five situations we are having for cost of acquisition. So first situation we know, second situation we are seeing. In second situation, whenever a capital asset is acquired by the SSE after 1/4/2001, whenever the asset is acquired by the SSE, that is after 1st April 2001, so we have to do cost of acquisition CII for the year in which the asset is transferred, CII for the year in which it is acquired. Okay, means this is purchased year, this the whole is means purchase year, and the whole is what, sale year. So for us always sale year is 1920. For us always the sale year will be 1920. Here also same, sale year will be 1920 always for us in this year, in this year the sale year will be 1920. Okay, so 1920 index we have to write. I'll show you what is the indexation. Inflation indexation, there is a table, the table we have to write here. Okay, that we have to write, and denominator we have to write CII for the year in which the asset is acquired by the acquired the purchase year. You can see purchase year, when the asset is purchased the indexation will be there, that we have to see. Clear? So first situation, what is the first situation? First situation is asset is acquired before 1/4/2001, 1st April 2001. So what you have to do, cost of acquisition, again two things you have to do, FMV or cost of acquisition, whichever is higher, okay, into sale year CII and CII of 2001 and 2 you have to write. And when the asset is purchased before 1st April 2001, the cost of acquisition directly you can write sale year CII and purchase year CII. The whole we can say purchase year CII, sale year CII and purchase year CII. Okay, okay. Two situations done now. Now see, we'll see third situation. When asset is acquired by before and the same is again acquired by the previous owner. Now what is saying now? Now what we are doing situation 3 now. See what we are saying in the situation 3, when an asset is acquired, what we are doing, we are acquiring asset, we are purchasing asset. By the SSE okay before 1st April 2001. Okay, we know what to do, same as first case again. What is same? and the same is originally acquired, and the same asset, and the same originally acquired by the previous owner prior means before 1st April 2001. What we are saying, whenever the asset is purchased by the SSE, when did he purchase? Before 1st April. And the previous owner from whom he purchased, he also purchased before 1/4/2001. So in that case, what we have to do, again same first case or first situation, how we have done, the same way we have to do. So formula will be, this will be given in question. See, these are what we, the situations which we are writing, this will be given in question, the same we are writing. Okay, next the formula will be same, cost of acquisition, how to do. Two things we are having, FMV or cost of acquisition, whichever is higher will be called as COA. Okay, cost of acquisition, whose we have to take? We have to take previous owner. Okay, we have to take cost of acquisition, whose cost of acquisition? Previous owner cost of acquisition we have to take, previous owner. This will be mentioned in question. The previous owner cost of acquisition, previous owner cost of acquisition we have to take, will be given in question. And fair market value also be, fair market value will be given. Okay, so higher, and again we know what to do, we have to multiply this with FMV or COA, multiply whole this with CII in the year in which asset is transferred. Divided by CII for the year 2001. Okay. So 2001, this year we have tried, and numerator we have tried CII in the year in which asset is transferred. This is always previous year. This is always previous year. This is third situation. What is the difference between first situation and third situation? First situation, the owner is himself buying the asset. The owner himself is buying the asset before 1st April 2001. Okay, here is the thing. But here what is happening? Third situation, the owner is acquiring the asset before 1st April 2001, and previous owner, the owner from whom he is purchased, that he also purchased before 1st April 2001. In that case, what we have to do, we have to write FMV or cost of acquisition, previous owner cost of acquisition, whichever is higher called, that we have to take, multiply that with previous year CII, and in the year CII of 2001 we have to do. And situation 3. Next, situation 4. What is situation 4 now? Situation 4, he is explaining where a capital asset, when a capital asset, now see the situations, is acquired by the SSE, is acquired, acquired means purchased, acquired by the SSE, acquired by the SSE, what we are saying, when a capital asset is acquired by the SSE, On or after 1st April 2001, this is important, the date is important, 1st April 2001, this is very much important, 1st April 2001, this is important. Okay, then, but it was originally acquired by, but it is originally acquired by previous owner before 1/4/2001, before 1st April 2001. Okay, so what we are saying, we are saying that whenever the asset is acquired, when the asset is acquired by the previous owner, by the SSE, before, after 1/4/2001, but it was originally purchased by the previous owner 1/4/2001. So we are getting confusion now, what is previous owner and all, I'll explain. Wait, see, this is a house property. Mr. X purchases house property on 1st April, take example 2005. Okay, so he purchased, Mr. X purchases house property on 1st April 2005. Okay, but the previous owner means to whom he purchased. Mr. X purchased from Mr. Y. Mr. Y is a previous owner. Actually, this property belongs to Mr. Y. Mr. Y sold this property to Mr. X. Okay, so Mr. Y will be called as previous owner. Understood? We are talking about Mr. X now. He is a owner now. But he purchased his property from Mr. X. Mr. Y is called previous owner. So this Mr. Y purchased the property before 1/4/2001. Before he purchased. But Mr. Y purchased after 1/4/2005. Means 1/4/2001 he purchased. So this situation we are understanding. Simple hai. Kuch bhi nahi dekho. Ek house property hai jiske do owners hai. Ek owner Mr. X hai, Mr. Y. Mr. X property kharida. Kab kharida? 1st April 2001 ke pehle kharida. ठीक है, वो खरीदा, थोड़े 4 साल रखा, 2005 में बेच दिया. किसको बेचा? मिस्टर एक्स को बेचा. हम किसके बारे में पढ़ रहे हैं? हम पढ़ रहे हैं मिस्टर एक्स के बारे में पढ़ रहे हैं. वी आर स्टडिंग अबाउट मिस्टर एक्स. ठीक है, आपको मिस्टर एक्स का कैपिटल गेन निकालना है. लेकिन क्वेश्चन में और बोल रहा है, ये जो प्रीवियस ओनर है, अभी मिस्टर एक्स को मिस्टर वाई क्या हो गया? प्रीवियस ओनर हो गया. ये बोल रहा है मिस्टर वाई जो है प्रीवियस ओनर, कब परचेस करा प्रॉपर्टी? 1st April 2001 के पहले परचेस करा. ये ने कब परचेस करा? एक्स बाद में परचेस करा. वही तो पढ़ रहे हैं हम लोग. वेन अ कैपिटल एसेट इज अक्वायर्ड बाय द एसएससी ऑनर आफ्टर 1/4/2001 के बाद परचेस करा ओनर. लेकिन ओरिजिनली जो उसका ओनर है, प्रीवियस ओनर जो एक्चुअल में ओनर है, उन्हें कब खरीदा? 1st अप्रैल एक्सक्यूज मी 2001 को परचेस करा. बिफोर परचेस करा, तो वही समझ रहे हैं हम लोग. तो ये केस में, ऐसे केस में कैसे करना चाहिए कॉस्ट ऑफ इंडेक्स कॉस्ट ऑफ एक्विजिशन? यहाँ क्या करेंगे हम लोग? फॉर्मूला लिखेंगे. डोंट वरी, विल राइट अ फॉर्मूला. ओके, विल राइट अ फॉर्मूला. कॉस्ट ऑफ एक्विजिशन सेम करेंगे, एफएमवी और सीओए. किसका सीओए? किसका सीओ लेंगे हम लोग? प्रीवियस ओनर का लेंगे. ये भी प्रीवियस ओनर का लेंगे. पीओ मीन्स प्रीवियस ओनर. इसमें जो भी हाईएस्ट रहेगा, विच एवर इज हायर, इसको मल्टीप्लाई करेंगे. किससे मल्टीप्लाई करेंगे? सी आई आई फॉर द ईयर सेम रहेगा हमेशा. फॉर द ईयर इन विच एसेट इज ट्रांसफर्ड. ओके, डिवाइड किससे करेंगे? सी आई आई फॉर विच for the year in which the asset was first held by SSE. Okay, SSE. So what we are saying, क्या लेंगे denominator में? CII for the year in which the asset was firstly held by the SSE. तो first कब खरीदा उन्हें वो लेंगे हम लोग. ठीक है, ये वाला ईयर. विल सी वेन वी डू द प्रॉब्लम्स, राइट? सो वी हैव सीन 4 सिचुएशंस. फर्स्ट सिचुएशन वी हैव सीन, बोल कर आया, व्हाट इज द फर्स्ट सिचुएशन? द एसेट इज अक्वायर्ड बिफोर 1st April 2001. ओनर खुद ओनर है, कोई दूसरा नहीं है. तो इन दैट केस व्हाट वी आर डूइंग, एफएमवी और सीओए विच एवर इज हायर मल्टीप्लाई करेंगे सेल ईयर का सीआईआई, और डिवाइड किससे करेंगे? सीआईआई 2001 एंड 2 का. ठीक है, नेक्स्ट, कैपिटल एसेट अक्वायर्ड करा एसएससी कब? 1st April 2001 के बाद. तो कॉस्ट ऑफ एक्विजिशन क्या करेंगे हम लोग? लिखेंगे एक ही कॉस्ट ऑफ एक्विजिशन रहेगा. सेल ईयर का लिखेंगे कॉस्ट ई आई आई, और परचेज ईयर का लिखेंगे सी आई आई. नेक्स्ट सिचुएशन 3, व्हेन द एसेट इज अक्वायर्ड बाय द प्रीवियस ओनर. एक्चुअल ओनर है, उन्हें भी 1st April 2001 के पहले परचेस करा, और जो रियल प्रीवियस ओनर है उन्हें भी 1st April 2001 के पहले परचेस करा. इन दैट केस वी विल डू सीओए एफएमवी और सीओए विच एवर इज हायर. सीओए किसका लेंगे? प्रीवियस ओनर. ये वाला ओनर पहले जो है हमारे एग्जाम्पल में कौन था? वाई था, उसका लेंगे. और क्या लिखेंगे? सी आई आई इन द ईयर ऑफ परचेज. डिवाइड किससे करेंगे? सी आई आई फॉर द ईयर 2001. सॉरी, दिस इज प्रीवियस ईयर. प्रीवियस ईयर का रहेगा ये, सेल ईयर बोलेंगे हम लोग, सेल ईयर का रहेगा. नेक्स्ट सेम 1920 रहेगा ये भी. नेक्स्ट, अब क्या बोल रहे हैं? एसएससी जो अक्वायर करा एसेट, कब परचेस करा? आफ्टर 1/4/2001 के करा, बट ओरिजिनली ये प्रीवियस ओनर कब लिया? 1st अप्रैल 2001 के लिया. तो इन दैट केस व्हाट वी हैव टू डू, एफएमवी और सीओए व्हिच एवर इज हायर मल्टीप्लाई करेंगे सेल ईयर से, ऑलवेज हमेशा 1920 रहेगा, ठीक है। सीआईए करेंगे फॉर द ईयर इन विच द एसेट इज वॉज फर्स्टली हेल्ड बाय द एसएससी, ये फर्स्ट एसएससी कब परचेज करा उसके बारे में लिखेंगे। चलिए लास्ट केस, अब क्या बोल रहे हैं, सब बिफोर बिफोर आया, अब आफ्टर आफ्टर करेंगे। सिचुएशन फाइव, व्हेन अ कैपिटल असेट इज अक्वायर्ड बाय द एसएससी ऑन और आफ्टर 1 अप्रैल 2001 एंड वॉज ओरिजिनली अक्वायर्ड बाई ओरिजिनली अक्वायर्ड बाई अब कौन परचेस करा इसको, ओरिजिनली कौन लिया इसको, अक्वायर्ड बाई प्रीवियस ओनर, इन्हें भी कब परचेस करा, ऑन एंड आफ्टर 1/4/2001, इन्हें भी बाद में खरीदा प्रीवियस ओनर, और जो करंट ओनर है उन्हें भी 2001 के बाद ही खरीदा। तो ये केस में क्या करेंगे, कॉस्ट ऑफ एक्विजिशन कैसे करेंगे, कॉस्ट ऑफ एक्विजिशन का मतलब क्या लिखेंगे पता है, यू नो एक्चुअल कॉस्ट टू द प्रीवियस ओनर, एक्चुअल कॉस्ट, ये प्रीवियस ओनर की बात कर रहे हैं, दिस विल बी गिवन इन क्वेश्चन, एक्चुअल कॉस्ट ऑफ प्रीवियस ओनर, प्रीवियस ओनर का ही लेंगे हम लोग, प्रीवियस ओनर, एक्चुअल कॉस्ट ऑफ प्रीवियस ओनर मल्टीप्लाई करेंगे, किससे मल्टीप्लाई करेंगे, मल्टीप्लाई सी आई आई इन द ईयर ऑफ, इन द ईयर विच द एसेट इज ट्रांसफर, डिवाइड किससे करेंगे, सी आई आई फॉर द ईयर इन विच एसेट इज ट्रांसफर फॉर द ईयर इन विच द एसेट विच वॉज फर्स्टली हेल्ड, क्या लिखेंगे, सी आई आई फॉर द ईयर इन विच एसेट इज ट्रांसफर इन इन विच एसेट इज फर्स्ट हेल्ड बाय द एसएससी, ठीक है। ये हो गए फाइव केसेस, इसके फाइव केसेस कॉस्ट ऑफ एक्विजिशन के, ओके। तो दिस विल बी आस्क्ड इन क्वेश्चन, एग्जाम में पूछेगा, क्वेश्चन में पूछेगा, तो क्वेश्चन देखना पड़ेगा वहाँ पर, कौन है ओनर, प्रीवियस ओनर है क्या, सिर्फ एक ही ओनर है क्या, कब परचेस करा, फर्स्ट